Hello and welcome to Anatomy with Dr. P. In today's video, we're going to be learning about the passageways that transport bile from the liver and gallbladder down into the duodenum. So as bile is collected by the small passageways inside of the liver, eventually all of that bile is going to drain down into our left and right hepatic ducts. The right hepatic duct drains the right side of the liver. The left hepatic duct drains the left side. So notice how they're these little green vessels. Now, as the left and right hepatic ducts leave the liver, they merge together to form a united passageway. This common passageway out of the liver is referred to as the common hepatic duct. Common because it's a common passageway, and hepatic because it's leaving the liver. Now, notice how coming off to the side, we have this passageway that goes over to our gallbladder. This passageway is known as the cystic duct. Cystic comes from a Greek word that means bladder. So cystic duct essentially means bladder duct because it's going to the gallbladder. When we have our gallbladders removed, that procedure is called a cholecystectomy. Ectomy means cutting. The cyst part of it refers to the cystic duct. Essentially, you go in and you cut the cystic duct and seal it shut. Now, where the cystic duct and the common hepatic duct join together, we now have bile draining from the liver and from the gallbladder. So this large passageway that forms after the merger of the common hepatic and cystic duct is called the common bile duct. And our common bile duct is going to carry bile from the liver and gallbladder all the way down to our hepatopancreatic ampulla. And at the hepatopancreatic ampulla, our common bile duct will merge together with the pancreatic duct and empty both bile and pancreatic juices out into the duodenum.